The commander can handle any of your questions.
All right. This is as far as I go. Take the lift up to Ops. Commander Ikande should be waiting for you.
Fleet call us sharks. They know what happens when we see red.
Excuse me.
Ah, there you are. Excellent. Now that we've established your level of cooperation with us, I want to introduce you to your new home. This is the Operations Center of the UC Vigilance. SysDev's nerve center, dedicated to the destruction of the Crimson Fleet. Whether this ship is impressive or not, you're the key element that we've been lacking. We need eyes and ears inside the Crimson Fleet. Someone who can feed us information, evidence, and expose their weaknesses. The catch is that you can't just knock on their front door and ask for an application. Getting inside is going to take some finesse. It certainly does. So listen up. Our intelligence has managed to find a possible opening into the Crimson Fleet through Sersha Bowden, one of their contacts. She works for the Trade Authority in Sidonia, so you'll be using a container of Aurora we've loaded on your ship to get her attention. That's right. So it'll be your job to convince this person that you're the real deal. Once you bluff your way into the Crimson Fleet, then the operation proceeds to evidence gathering. That's where my second-in-command, Lieutenant Gillian Toft, comes into the picture. She'll explain everything you need to know. If I didn't have confidence in your abilities, we wouldn't be having this conversation. Remember, this entire operation rests on your ability to infiltrate the Crimson Fleet and bring us the evidence we need to take them down. Fine. Whatever gets the job done. Look, before you begin, I want to make something perfectly clear. As an undercover operative for UC SysDev, you'll be expected to follow our code of conduct and ethics. Allow yourself to stray too far off the path, and you stand a good chance of spiraling out of control. To put it simply, you can't go into every situation with guns blazing. Think before you act. Calculate what you're doing and pull the trigger only when it's absolutely necessary. At the end of the day, your primary goal is taking down the Crimson Fleet. That's the greater good. I don't want promises. I'm just asking you to think. Anyway, it's time to hand you over to Lieutenant Toft. She'll brief you about the details of the evidence-gathering portion of the operation. Now, get out of here, and good luck. For your own safety, nobody but myself and the crew of the Vigilance will be aware that you're working for the United Colonies. Basically, if you land in jail, you're going to have to deal with the fines. All we know is that she's been with the Trade Authority for years, which means she's been privy to some seriously shady deals. She's shrewd and she's diligent. The only reason we were able to connect her with the Crimson Fleet at all was thanks to an informant. I'm afraid she's the best lead we've got. While you're running with the Crimson Fleet, you're undoubtedly going to be faced with some morally gray decisions. It's going to be difficult for you to weigh the consequences of pulling the trigger while maintaining your cover. Do what you have to do, but remember why you're out there in the first place. That's why I expect you to constantly seek alternative means to overcome your obstacles, rather than blowing holes in them. Look, I can see that you're struggling with this, so let me simplify this for you. If there's a route to your goal which doesn't involve killing innocent people, I'm urging you to follow that path. Use your instincts. I'm certain you'll do the right thing. That's easy to answer. You don't. We'll be monitoring your activities from the Vigilance and attempting to keep it within your vicinity. When you feel you've gathered enough evidence and at the completion of your assignments, head back here for a debrief. Beyond that, you're completely on your own. Dismissed.
Pardon?
Yeah? Time to go? I'm listening. It's all important, but if you want a direction, I'd grab Barrett first. He's not just an old friend. He's been all over the settled systems. Talk to you later.
Hello.
Carrying enough clutter there, and should we find some more?
Pardon?
We don't have a lot of time, so I need you to listen up. While you're working undercover, it's imperative that you gather as much evidence as possible. If you find any records that look suspicious or incriminating, you bring it to me. Is that understood? You better make it, because Commander Akande cashed in all his chips to get this operation off the ground. I want data slates, computer downloads, handwritten notes. Hell, I'll take anything if it'll get those bastards thrown into the brig. It's not you, it's the Crimson Fleet. That minor skirmish you had with them on Vectera was nothing compared to the death and destruction those pirates leave behind. If you've seen what I've seen, you'd understand why I'm pushing you so hard. Yes, of course. I'm sorry if I brought up any painful memories. Oh, one last thing. A bit of good news, actually. Commander Akande has authorized a credit disbursement for each piece of evidence that you return, as compensation for your efforts. Commander Akande came up with the idea. He was concerned you might not help us simply because it was the right thing to do. All right. We've loaded a container of Aurora into your ship's cargo hold. We're also providing you with a sample you can use to tease the goods. We've cleared your ship for launch. Proceed to Cydonia. Make contact with Seersha Bowden, And with any luck, she'll point you to the Crimson Fleet. That should do it. You're dismissed. Not really, no. I've learned to keep my personal experiences separate from the job. Yeah. Maybe. No, it's not really an appropriate time to be going over my private life. There are much more important things to be done. Let's just stick to the job at hand and concentrate on the mission. But, maybe we can talk about it some other time, okay? Don't worry, the container's been registered with UC Security, so you shouldn't have any trouble. Even if you're scanned. Of course, if we find out you tried to sell it to someone outside the boundaries of this particular operation, well, I don't think I need to tell you the consequences of making that mistake.
Oh, yeah?
We'll be keeping them close at hand until this operation is complete. So, we'll be holding them in the Vigilance's brig. If you're feeling particularly ruthless, you could always head down there and say hello. I'm sure they'll be thrilled to see you. I'll be here if you have any more questions.
Okay, hello.
I woke up in the middle of the night once and found Ensign Betty tinkering with some machine. Does she ever sleep?
I could have joined any division of the UC Navy. I chose Sister.
The pirates have a propaganda.
I mean, there is such a killing something.
Oh, hello. I don't think we've met. Are you by chance new here?
Whatever it takes to get your friends, the easiest way is to kill the person holding.
Wait, I know that name. You're that dangerous ex-convict everyone is talking about. Well, don't worry. I'm not scared of you. My godmother was a member of the Strikers gang, and you're not even half as scary as her. My name is Javanta. I'm an ensign with the maintenance and robotics team. And just between you and me, I don't think you're dangerous. Do you? Aren't we all? I know people look at me funny when I say I'm from Neon, like it's some alien planet where only debauchery is allowed. But first of all, every planet is alien. Second of all, it is perfectly okay to be normal on Neon. No one's going to arrest you for staying home and watching TV. Anyway, it was very nice to meet you. If you want to talk some more, I will be here. It's a good question. It was what you'd call a minor moral crisis. I wasn't happy with my old job at Drone. I felt like my life was on an assembly line. Everything was about profit, and nothing had any real meaning. But then it occurred to me, if I'm so miserable, I could just leave. So one day I just did. Sistef is far from perfect, but our goal is noble. I can sleep soundly, knowing my work will be for a cause that is just. Oh, I'm part of the maintenance team that makes sure the Vigilance is operating smoothly. On the robotic side, I take care of the Model A's on the ship, and make sure they're treated with respect and dignity. They are people, after all, just like us. See? I knew there was something I liked about you. Machines are very dear to me. Think of it this way. How can we expect a robot to fight by our side if we won't fight for their right to exist? So I always do my best to treat them as my equals. Oh, I have so many questions. There is not enough time to ask them all. But I will be respectful of your criminal history as it is in the past. We must look forward. Instead, I will ask you a very simple question. Are you a morning, afternoon, or night person? Oof, then we can't be friends. No, I'm kidding. Of course. But I prefer the early hours myself. Do I? I guess that's a compliment. Everything is just better in the morning. The food, the air, the coffee. But the thing I like best is the quiet. When I can look out into space and see the whole galaxy is asleep. When it's that quiet, the only noise you hear is from the Vigilance itself. In fact, we keep each other company when the world is too busy snoring in their beds. Makes it so the mornings are just for us. Don't be a stranger. Nah, I don't think enough All right then.
Howdy. Excuse me. Hello.
Commander Ikande is the heart and soul of UC SysDef. I'd follow him to the ends of the galaxy.
I'm not authorized to answer your questions. Just shut up and do as you're told. The commander can handle any of your questions. Just shut up and do as you're told.
Yes. What?
I don't know about you. Isn't it? We've got plenty of fresh faces picked right from the Academy, but yours happen to come from a different farm. The prison one, if we're being honest. But if Commander Ikande says you're SysDef, then you are one of us. For now. You guessed it. In fact, I'd say you've got what linguistic experts call FOGO, a firm grasp of the obvious. But I'm not just any pilot. I'm the best, and I've got the kills to prove it. Don't squeeze too hard, newbie. Someone might mistake it for sarcasm. Long story. I got my start in the Academy and made a name for myself hunting the Crimson Fleet. I eventually got recruited to do test flights on a star station orbiting Loyden's Rock. Me and three other Archangel pilots did some work on some extremely dangerous prototypes. But I called in a few favors and got back home with SysDef. Someone with my talents needs to be here, where the action is. I cut my teeth on space trucks, believe it or not. Before I got my stripes, I was just another cargo hauler trying to earn an honest wage. But after a couple slick escapes, I got recruited to the Academy and went from dodging pirates to hunting them. Thing is, some of my best tricks were with a big rig. Ever try a pitchback with a Hope Tech truck with two fleet wraiths on your tail? Compared to that, doing it with a military fighter is a piece of cake. Stay frosty.
Moving.
I like to think of myself as your emotional support human. Has anyone ever told you what's mine is yours? course. I'm an open book. Read me, write me, listen to me on your preferred electronic device. It's all fine. Well, for one, your triumph on Vectera was all over the news. But I believe that's only the beginning. The first chapter in a 437-book anthology documenting your greatness. It's only a matter of time before they start writing it. I'll be counting the seconds until they do. 1001, 1002. Oh, I'm not that interesting. I like coffee, I like tea, and I like worshipping the ground you walk on. Well, you technically don't walk. Angels tend to glide. Oh, don't worry. My love for you is completely platonic. Unbreakable, yes. Unyielding, absolutely. Romantic? Oh, God, no. I would never sully something so pure with something so ordinary. Oh, no. That sounds ominous. Or I could stand beside you and make you my chief interest. That sounds much better. Oh, good. For a second I thought you were about to say something mean, which would completely knock over the giant pedestal I've placed you on. How do you think this adventure is going? Great? Fantastic? A moment in time we'll treasure forever? Of course. Of course. I'm sure you have all the answers already. Back to work, then.
Too many alternate ends.
Thank you. the day, Captain. I will follow behind you.
I'll get back to what I was doing. You know where to find me.
Don't touch anything. This is a particle fracking facility. Best case scenario, you break something. Worst case, you detonate at Mars. Am I ever glad to see you? We need your help. A band of Crimson Fleet have been extorting us. I guess they can smell the credits from across the system. I know it's not your problem, but we're not up for that kind of trouble. Can you help us? Thank you. Stay safe out there.
Keep shields up, seals. Always could use a hand. Current details are listed on the mission terminal. Help yourself.
Squeezing every last drop of ore we can manage out of this rock. We head back to Cydonia tomorrow, and the bosses are gonna be pissed if the cargo hold isn't stuffed to the gills. Time to get back to it.
Thank you.
his room in my... I will await your... Captain, hello. Farewell. Hello, Captain. Do you require a... Goodbye, Captain.
spacer ship, but then I realize my tank sprung a leak. I'm stuck. And the only place close enough to land... Wait.
You're not suggesting.
Let me know if I may assist you. You won't find a larger array of options in all this. I'm sure you'll be set. Your patronage is appreciated.
Need something but don't have a... Come on in. Yeah, sure thing. Take a look. Be seeing you.
Something to be said for only the fun.
Stay there.
There are so many options.
Then a Trish... Information is the same for... Welcome to Chunks. I'm happy to serve you.
Order anything.
What am I in the mood for today?
If I've answered each and every question, may I help?
I cannot believe this guy.
How many calories is that?
There are other customers waiting.
You'll find my pen pal Hattie in store.
Thank you.
I do hope you are enjoying your time in New Atlantis.
Funny stuff with that boost pack. Not enough light traffic as it is.
I cannot wait to meet her.
And you must be the latest poor fool to get dragged into our dysfunctional little family. Whoa. I know a few dark sides of the Aquila moons, but if you're looking for deep history lessons, well, I'm gonna fall asleep before you do.
Trust me. Don't encourage him. Kuriko, by the way. Hi, hi. It helps to have a good teacher. Dad, don't let it go to your head.
A compliment from little Cora. It's not even my birthday. Now, let's talk business. Sarah tell you about the expedition? Sure enough, that's where we're heading. The three of us are heading to Aquila, for a settled planet of the Freestar Collective and, not coincidentally, the home of their capital, Aquila City. We'll land in the city's spaceports, but the frontier is our goal. It's rough country, spawned a lot of stories. And I got a lead on a tale that makes me think one thing. Artifact. Okay, we'll meet you on board your ship. Talk more when we get there. Once we land on Aquila, it's gonna be you and me. So if you want to do any freewheeling before then, Cora and I will just be riding passenger.
Can I ask you something, Mr. Stroud?
Of course, Miss Cope.
You're the richest person.
Je peux vous aider?
Thank you. And he's our new captain. My crew can take a look at your ship. Sure, have at it. I would try the viewport. It'll be on your left once you get into the plaza. Everything looks good here. I'll be at my booth if you need me.
Appreciate the lift. Now, once we... I found some stuff. Nothing too exciting, but it's yours.
must be great to be able to see yourself when... That was a good talk. It'll be hard to top it. Whenever I'm lost, I think, what would you do in my shoes? Not literally, though. I've got small.
Dad and I will be riding passenger with you. The most boring job in space travel. Bye!
Star system Cheyenne is what you're looking for. Planet of Aquila.
talk to while I'm on the ship by myself?
Give him an inch. We'll see you come down.
Thank you. You're good. Welcome to Aquila City.
Here. You ready? Because once we get started, I'm gonna be riding your tail till this is over. All right, but don't take too long, or Cora's gonna get bored and start disassembling things.